शंखं चक्रं जलौकां दधदमृतघटं चारु दोर्भिश्चतुर्भिः सूक्ष्मस्वच्छातिहृद्यांशुक परिविलसन् मौलिमं भोजनेत्रं कालांभोदोज्ज्वलांगं कटितटविलसच्चारुपीताम्बराढ्यं वंदे धन्वंतरिं तं
मैनेजमेंट ऑफ मेजर डिसऑर्डर इट वॉज वर्क वॉज सुपरवाइज्ड बाय डॉक्टर दयाशंकर मिश्रा असोसिएट प्रोफेसर NIIT जयपुर एंड को सुपरविजन वॉज बाय डॉक्टर अलोक त्यागी Department of Psychiatry Associate Professor SMS College Jaipur. The topic is MDD, that is Major Depressive Disorder. It is a mental disorder characterized by low mood accompanied by low self-esteem, and there is loss of interest or pleasure in normally enjoyable activities. When we look for the global aspect of this disease, it is the fourth leading contributor of DALIS, that is Disabilities Adjusted Life Year, and it might be second by the year 2020. We know that in modern medications there is antidepressant medication, which means 50% of the MDD patients were treated by antidepressant medication, but most of them discontinues the treatment only because modern medication has unpleasant side effects, insufficient response, and it is time consuming and expensive also, and there is always pharmacological compliance in the antidepressant treatment after particular period. So there is arrival of the question, because there is failure of the treatment in modern medical science, so patient has attention for the effective Ayurvedic medication. So in Ayurveda, Ayurvedic herbs may offer advantage in terms of safety, tolerability, and they might give the promising results with cost-effective medication in the patient of depression. So material and methods of the study. Study is non-blinded, randomized controlled clinical trial, and the study population was collected from OPD and IPD of the Tajikistan Department, NII Hospital, and OPD of Psychiatry, SMS Medical College and Hospital, Jaipur. Total screened patients for the study were 34, and out of which 30 patients were enrolled for the study. All these patients were completed the study, which were taken into two groups, group A and group B, and treatment is given for 6 weeks. Selection criteria for the study: subjects of age more than 20 and less than 60 years of age were selected for the study. Subjects who fulfilled the criteria for DSM-4 were included in the study. Subjects who are having mild to moderate major depressive disorder, having minimal total score at least 10 and maximum 18 of the Hamilton Depression Rating Scale, item 17 at baseline visit. Subjects who agree for all the required tests for trial and all the examinations which are necessary for the trial, and subjects who willing for sign the consent form were included in the study. The exclusion criteria for the study: subjects less than 20 years of age, subjects more than 60 years of age, pregnant ladies or the ladies who are on breastfeeding or planning to become pregnant during the study, current history of illness with hepatic, renal or gastrointestinal disease or any respiratory or cardiovascular problem, any endocrinological, neurological, immunological or hematological diseases or infectious diseases. All these subjects were excluded from the study. Significantly abnormal laboratory tests and finding of the ECG were also excluded from the study. Current use of any drug abuse or alcohol dependence, and diagnosis of panic disorder, generalized anxiety, dementia, bipolar disorder, schizophrenia or any other psychiatric disorders were excluded from the study. Patients were unable to give the informed consent and follow up for the study procedure were also excluded from the study. No diagnostic criteria used for the study. There are DSM-4 criteria in which there are listed symptoms are there. Out of which depressed mood and loss of interest were the important symptoms. At least one of these two symptoms should be there in patient for the inclusion criteria. Along with that, patient should have 5 or more of the following symptoms. It is significant weight loss or gain, insomnia or hypersomnia, psychomotor agitation or retardation, then fatigue or loss of energy, feelings of worthlessness or excessive or inappropriate guilt, diminished ability to think. Diminished ability to think or concentrate, recurrent thoughts of death, recurrent suicidal ideation without a specific plan or suicide attempts or a specific plan. Next criteria for diagnosis was ICD, International Classification of Disease 10 for depressive disorder. Here also depressed mood, loss of interest and enjoyment and reduced energy were the main symptoms, out of which at least two there should be in the patient. And other common symptoms are reduced concentration and attention, reduced self-esteem and self-confidence, ideas of guilt and unworthiness, negative views of the future, suicidal tendency, disturbed sleep, diminished appetite. The manipulation of drugs with the duration, there were two groups, group 1 and group 2. Group 1 was given standard drug fluoxetine 20 mg per oral twice a day for 42 consecutive days, and in group 2 the patient were given 3 gram herbal preparation thrice a day for 42 consecutive days and Shirodhara therapy for medicated plain ashwagandha oil for 14 consecutive days. The herbal formulation contains nodules such as Gadamasi, that is Gadamasi, and Lavendula stickers, that is Ustekhadus. In equal proportion, they were combined and herbal capsule were made. Then for the efficacy measurement, Hamilton Depression Rating Scale Item 7 was used. Then Clinical Global Impression Severity Scale was administered at the day of baseline, 14th day, 28th day and 42nd day of the study. Clinical Global Impression Improvement Scale was administered at all post-baseline visits. Then for the safety measurement, all the adverse effects were monitored at each visit of day of the patient. The laboratory examinations were measured at baseline day and the day 42. Then observation and results. When a patient was observed clinically, all randomized patients of MDD were shows the following results. Here we look that in the patient, in the symptoms, diminished interest or pleasure, insomnia or hypersomnia, fatigue or loss of energy every day. All these three symptoms showed statistically significant result with p-value less than 0.01. Then Hamilton Depression Rating Scale and Clinical Global Impression Severity Scale was applied to this study. It shows highly significant result in both the group, that is group A and group B. In case of CGI improvement score scale, here also there is highly significant result were shown in both the groups. Basically, when we look for the adverse effect, we come across in the group 1, which was a group of modern medication, that is fluoxetine, most of the patients shows adverse effect like dry mouth, headache, nausea, somnolence, sweating, restlessness, constipation, dizziness, sexually dysfunction and anorexia. Whereas the group 2, where herbal preparation with Shirodhara was used, only 2% of the patient shows sweating as an adverse effect. So it is the positive point for our Ayurvedic medication. Effect on laboratory examinations. When patients were assessed for laboratory examinations in case of hematological or biochemical or KFT, LFT or total lipid profile and ECG, there was no significant result or no significant change was observed in both the groups. This shows that both the medications are cytotoxically, means there is no cytotoxicity of the drugs within this particular duration of the time. Then discussion, depression is tough predominant disease where there is auron of the tamaguna, and all the selected drugs used in this study shows the opposite character of kapha dosha, and which may have the property to break down the auron of the tamaguna and increase in the sattva guna, and that may also nourishes the sadhak pitta. Then shirodhara helps change the psycho-neuro-immunological function of brain, leading to change in the level of various neurotransmitters, resulting in sympathetic suppression and physio-immunological changes of peripheral circulation. Shirodhara may help to make a interpersonal relationship between patients and prescribers during the therapy that focuses on the interpersonal behavior. Then conclusion of the study. This study suggests that selective herbal preparation and shirodhara therapy can be used in mild to moderate condition of major depressive disorder. It is well tolerated and with no side effects. It is a highly significant result with the cost effective management in case of major depressive disorder. Thank you.